Welcome everybody, my name is William, and I am the Gamer Dad. In this video, we'll be looking at how to steal from the poor and keep the rich powerful. That's right, today we look at Prince John. Prince John is from the Disney classic Robin Hood. Before we get into the strategy, I wanted to give you my perspective on where I place Prince John with difficulty to play and the strategy required to play him. On a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being extremely simple and 5 being extremely difficult, we placed Prince John around 2 for difficulty, with a required strategy level of about 3. Prince John's objective is straightforward and simple. You must collect and start your turn with 20 power. Now let's take a closer look at the game board. In this realm you'll find Sherwood Forest, Friar Tuck's Church, Nottingham, and the Jail. You'll notice right away that the jail does not have any actions across the top of its location. This will come in handy when dealing with heroes fated to the board. Even if a hero is played to the jail, you'll have 3 actions to use, including gaining 3 power. This makes this location a priority to visit every other turn for a quick bump in power. Looking over the rest of the board, each location will grant you access to power gains and a chance to play a card. Keep in mind that all your power gains can be blocked by heroes anywhere but the jail. Sherwood Forest grants you 1 power, a discard ability, a play a card ability, and a fate action. Friar Tuck's Church grants you 2 power. You have 2 play a card chances and a move a card action. Finally, Nottingham grants you 1 power, a chance to play a card, a fate action, and then the very important Vanquish action, which will come into play when the power gains are slow due to Robin Hood and his allies. Power is the focus here, and it can become easy to get distracted with heroes entering the realm. Stay focused and try to avoid spending power until absolutely necessary. If you want to play allies to the board, consider placing a single Rhino Guard, or Trigger, when possible, and building them up with items. Rhino Guards and Trigger each have 4 strength, and with the right items played, can take down most heroes with ease. Item cards such as Golden Arrow and Bow and Arrows will add extra benefits to risking the use of power. Golden Arrow will award you with 2 power when attached to an ally who defeats a hero. Bow and Arrows will allow you to discard the item instead of the ally, giving that ally a second chance to protect Prince John's journey. If you've been fated multiple times and have heroes all over the realm, things can seem hard. Luckily for the coward prince, effect cards could swing the action of your opponents into major power plays. Keeping hold of a beautiful, lovely Taxes in your hand will help you net 1 power for each hero in the realm, and placing a warrant at each location is a smart move that'll help you bag 2 power each time a hero is played where the warrant sits. If those pesky heroes have pushed you to your limits and you have no option but to use power, Imprison will allow you to move the hero to the jail, hopefully freeing up some actions for you. Condition cards should be played often and quickly, as each one of them has instant benefit for you. Cowardice will allow you to play an ally for free from your hand if any other player has 3 or more allies in their realm. And Greed gives you 3 power if anybody has 6 power or more. Both of these cards work out great when playing with groups of 3 or more players. Heroes in this realm can be tough. While it may be tempting to eliminate smaller heroes early, like Toby or Skippy, consider the hardest heroes to beat have 5 or 6 strength and will take multiple allies to defeat them. Some heroes, when played to the board, will even steal power from Prince John and hold on to it until they're defeated, so plan to ride a roller coaster with your power throughout the game. While Prince John's objective is simple in itself, the number of times I've watched my power count drop to single digits is amazing. Here are 2 tips I feel can help you swing the game to your advantage. Number 1, stack items and allies, often. Look to build up a single ally, using the least amount of power. In a pinch, defeating a hero may be the only option you have left to restart that power climb. So don't stress yourself out later in the game, when others' objectives are becoming closer to fulfillment. Build up an ally, stockpile power, act when needed, repeat. And tip number 2, discard cards. I know it sounds ridiculous, I can't tell you the number of times that I've forgotten that I can discard and ignore it. There's something in our brains when we play card games that tells us to hang on to what we have, and it seems all too tempting to hang on to those 2 beautiful, lovely Taxes cards, or a condition card early in the game. If the timing isn't right, and doesn't look to be heading that way anytime soon, get rid of it. Work to cycle through the deck. Discarding is often an overlooked action, but to win with Prince John, you'll need your opponents to be distracted long enough for you to sneak power throughout the game and replenish what you've spent. Don't waste the chance to draw another helpful card because you've held on to four really good cards hoping for that perfect moment. That's pretty much it for my strategy guide for Prince John. He's one of my favorite characters to play, and he's a great starter to use when you're learning how to play Villainous for the first time. I hope this guide gives you a few ideas on how to adjust your own playstyle and master the villain. If you've enjoyed the video, a thumbs up is very much appreciated. Feel free to leave a comment below and let me know what you think and what you like most about playing Prince John. I'll be back with more strategy guides for Villainous as well as more games in the future. With that, thanks for watching, you guys. Game on, and be kind to one another. Ooh, da lolly.